Hearty welcome to all of you. Today we are here to discuss methods section of a research paper, which is an essential part to get the results and conclusions. Let us start with what is it? Very first one, it is also referred as materials and methods. Next, in the methods section, we were able to get the explanation of the procedures or techniques that are we are going to implement or execute on some object or a samples what we have selected for our particular research work. Later, the method section is that which gives us the real value which is suitable for the concerned problem and application. Later, we are to see here method section, why is it so important in a research paper? Coming to the point, to judge easily means it will help us to justify or judge how the selected method is valid and reproducible and is giving us the fruitful results in our research work. Later, we have to say that the results and conclusions, whatever we get in a research work, they directly depend upon the methods section because we deal there with different sets of methodologies and algorithms. Next is this method section, as we said, it has the tendency of having the soul of the paper or of the work. It will help us to get a solution in clear and legible manner. Next one, the final and important section here, in the method section, we referred as contents. What are there available in the method section? Very first thing, we used to tend to write the existing methods for the concerned research topic or area of interest in the research work. Once we frame them in a line with respect to the literature search, what we have done for our work, we will make a tabular column of that with respect to different parameters and have a knowledge about those methods. Later, based upon those methods, when we prepare some proposed method and algorithm, we have to write about the proposed method, what we have prepared here, based upon the existing method, based upon the various literature searches, we decide on the proposed method. Once we propose the method, we write the pseudo algorithm of the proposed method. Pseudo algorithm can also be referred to as a simple flow of steps, like from the start to the end button, how the particular methodology or method works, like starting from the initiation of the variables to the logic, how we write the formulae of the particular problem and how we execute it and how we get the results. We write those things in the form of a pseudo algorithm. Pseudo means it is half correct. We can also call it as pseudo code or pseudo source code. Later, we induce in the method section with respect to the pseudo algorithm, what we have mentioned there, we prepare a process flow. It can be a process flow, it can be a flow chart, or it can be a block diagram also. It depends upon which type of conditions you are going through. Later, once the flow chart or process flow is finalized, we go with the implementation with respect to the system specifications, what type of requirements are required, like apparatus, equipment, tools, software tools, and all the software and hardware requirements. We make a list of them. Once we have make a list of them, we go to implement it. If it is hardware, we go to deal with it in a different way. If it is completely a software simulation research work, we deal in a different way. Means whatever we take, we have to inform or place the specifications in a clear manner such that our research work is in the further work, it can be reproducible and can be obtained as a result, and they can get a good results. This is about the method section of a research paper or research article. Hope you have clearly understood the simple concepts about method section. If you like our video, kindly share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.